How do you compare different time periods in Google Analytics? What time periods should you compare? And how do you avoid misleading metrics? All this and more on this episode of Whole World TV. First, to get on the same page, let's talk about why this is important. Comparing time periods allows you to see how traffic has increased or decreased across time, what traffic channels have contributed to this increase or decrease, if there are any tracking issues or fires you need to address, and if you're driving impact by increasing conversion rate for key performance indicators tracked in Google Analytics as goals. By comparing time periods, you can gather the information that matters, analyze it to find patterns or problems, and then take action based on those insights.
Log into your Google Analytics, and when you go to your home, move to Reports and choose one of those. For this example, we'll look at Acquisition, Overview, and then it will pull up the date range. Usually, it will be the last 7 days. So we're going to customize that and choose January 1st, 2017 to December 31st, 2017 to look at that full year. When you apply that, it will apply to all the data, so you'll be looking at traffic from that full year. To compare to the previous year or to another time period, click again and then check compare to, and then you can look at a custom time range, previous period or previous year. We'll apply previous period, and then you can see the data from both time periods together so that you can compare and contrast.
Not all months have the same number of days, so we recommend comparing to previous period to get the most accurate data. Likewise, when comparing periods, remember that web traffic is seasonal. You run different campaigns at different times of year, and people tend to be less active online in the summer and in December. If you want to better understand how traffic performed in a span of months, then compare to the same span of months the year prior, rather than just the previous month. Finally, note that Google Analytics takes about a day to gather all the data, so we wouldn't recommend pulling a year-over-year or month-over-month insight report until a few days into the year or month. To help you get started, here are a few ideas for how you can use Google Analytics custom time periods to your advantage. Year-over-year reports. See how traffic is performing this year compared to last year. Are you growing? Hint, you want to be growing. Quarter over quarter. To reach your annual goals, track your progress each quarter. This will allow you to stay on top of those goals that we often forget about until the last minute. Sprint over sprint and month over month. We recommend running a fire check every sprint or every 2 weeks. Look at the last 2 weeks versus the 2 weeks prior, and then look at month over month. Are your goals tracking? Are there any crazy dips in traffic? Are those dips on purpose, or is data getting lost? Make sure you address any issues immediately. We've already touched on comparing periods in order to compare apples to apples, but there is another common analytics pitfall to avoid. Quick quiz. Turtle, our puppy whaler, is tracking Whole Whale site traffic. She sets the custom date range for June to August and finds that there were 2,000 users. She isn't certain that that's correct, so she looks at each month individually and finds that in June there were 1,500 users, in July there were 1,000, and in August there were 1,200 users, a total of 3,700 users. How is that possible? Google Analytics uses cookies to track unique users over time. So there were 1,500 unique users in June, but many returned in the following months. Overall, there were 2,000 unique computers or people checking out Whole Whale site in those summer months. When looking at unique users, page views, or similar seasonal metrics, be sure to look at the overall time period to get the most accurate number. Bet you didn't think you'd be doing math when you started this video, but being aware of how data can be misleading and asking the right questions will allow you to find richer insights to inform a more successful digital strategy. Now, go turn back time with Google Analytics, and for more resources, subscribe to our channel and check out our website, wholewhale.com.